You know, that was really the difference that I set out to make with this project, was I can make this kind of difference for my family, for my son, and together we can make the same difference for other families and other children living with type 1 diabetes. Okay, I'm gonna have to just quit out of this. Hi, thank you for being here today. My name is Josh Wolf, and I'm one of the developers of Minecraft for type 1 diabetes. And it's really an honor and a privilege to be with you here today for the official launch of Minecraft for type 1 diabetes. My son, Prahlad, has type 1 diabetes, and he played Minecraft. And so that's kind of how this whole thing got started.
I was 8 years old, and when I got diagnosed, I was really sick and I didn't feel very well. None of my neighbors knew about it. I think like two of my friends knew about it. No one really knew about it, no one really helped me with it. So it was just like me, mom and dad, just trying to figure out type 1 diabetes by ourselves. And it was like just us drowning in a sea of information of like doctors, nurses, psychiatrists, like heaps of people coming in and out, talking to us. And I'm 8 at the time, so I don't know what's going on.
When Prahlad was in primary school, maybe a year or so after he was diagnosed, another girl in his class was diagnosed. And the teacher asked me to come in and talk to the class about it, to explain it to them. I was dropping a lot of information on them, and I walked out of there just going, they're not going to remember any of that. I saw his friends, you know, they wanted to support him and they wanted to help him. But one of the things that they struggled with was that they didn't understand how it worked. And for him, he's like, I didn't ask to have type 1 diabetes, and I sure as heck did not ask to become a type 1 diabetes educator for everyone else around me. So I saw that we could give a whole lot of information in a way that they could consume it, because kids learn the most complex things in Minecraft. They're like typing all these commands and doing all kinds of stuff. They just naturally pick it up.
And he thought of like all the other children with diabetes in like Australia or around the world. And he thought if he could make a difference around that, he could really make a change.
That impact that we experience in life must be there for, you know, every human being who lives with these conditions of life.
And Minecraft was like something that I was playing at the time, so he just correlated the two. And I guess this is what it came up with.
And so that's kind of how it started, and it took me a while to sort of figure out exactly what I was going to do, but yeah, Minecraft for type 1 diabetes came out of that conversation. You know, like I'm living with my son having type 1 diabetes, and it impacts me and it impacts us. There must be so many other people in the world living in that same kind of condition of life, and maybe I could make a difference to that. And maybe I could take this platform that we developed for teaching kids to code in Minecraft, and we could make a version of Minecraft where the player has type 1 diabetes. So thank you very much for being here, and I now declare Minecraft for type 1 diabetes officially launched. It's like a virtual reality simulator, so there's no risk to their life when they're playing Minecraft, and so they can really experiment with like what it is to live with type 1 diabetes and the different consequences of, you know, taking their insulin, not taking their insulin, what happens when they eat food, that kind of stuff.
Being a type 1 diabetic is hard, and most people don't know how hard it is. They simply just don't know what it's like to live with that all the time. The game gives them a very tangible way of experiencing that.
Having been on the same journey, being diagnosed, it's a really big thing to get your head around. So any other way of explaining it or understanding it, even for my daughter to be able to talk with her friends about it using Minecraft is great.
They get to see what it's like. They get to experience the ebbs and flows, the ups and downs.
I think if MCT1 was to go global, it would just improve the lives of kids living with diabetes. I really do believe that there would be a much greater understanding for those children themselves, but also for other people about what it means to live with type 1 diabetes.
If I had a game like this when I first got diabetes, it would have helped me understand what it's like to see it every day, because I was hospitalized for however long, so I was watched by doctors and then sent out into the world, off you go. This would have let me play it and see it and see the ups and downs rather than living them. So I guess it would have made my transition that much easier, and I want to see other kids experience that positivity.
It really does draw attention to what it might mean to have diabetes.
The difference that I can, you know, make in other people's lives and that this project can make in people's lives. And to keep it going over time, it takes something. But like in moments like this where I get present to the real difference that it makes, it's like all worth it.
I guess at a global level, we would want MCT1 to be like played all around the world, so you connect like kids together and they can have fun playing Minecraft while also learning about type 1 diabetes.
I feel like we're making the world a better place.